Welcome to Strength of Materials. In this video, let us see related to the numericals of compound stresses. So as we have seen the three numericals, in this we are going to see the fourth numerical. In the fourth numerical, what are the data is given? Direct stresses of magnitude 120 megapascal tensile and 80 megapascal compressive are acting at a point along with shear stress of 50 newton per mm square. Compute the normal and tangential stresses on the plane at 40 degree anti-clockwise, they are mentioning, with the plane on which 120 MPa megapascal tensile stress is acting. Also, compute the magnitude of principal stresses and planes, sketch the stresses and their planes. So, let us see related to this particular numerical, what is the particular part and how to solve the particular numerical. So, as we have seen, the particular values are given in this. One is tensile stress of 120 megapascal tensile, and 180 megapascal the compressive stress is acting, as well as the shear stress of 50 newton per mm square. Then they are giving the anti-clockwise inclined part is going to act. Anti-clockwise, the rotation will be in the anti-clockwise direction we have to consider. So let us begin with the solution part. So, solution. So, first we are going to draw the particular element, two dimensional element. And one is compressive, one is tension. So, let us take this as compressive, this as tension, which is acting on the particular part of the thing. So this is sigma x, this is sigma y, and anti-clockwise shear stress is acting, means we will take anti-clockwise shear stress in this direction. So anti-clockwise means in this direction it is going to act in this way, and we are in the this particular downward way, which we will take it as tau x y. Then they are going to give the angle, which is 40 degrees. So 40 degrees angle, let us take that 40 degree angle, which will be from here this way. This is theta, which is equals to 40 degrees. Okay, so I will take the naming A, B, C, D, and this as E. Okay, so this part is the particular part. Let us write down what are the given values. In the given values part, sigma x is equals to 120 newton per mm square. Sigma y is equals to 80 newton per mm square, and comes the tau xy value is equals to 50 newton per mm square. Then theta value is given as 40 degrees anticlockwise, it is acting anticlockwise. So this is the rotation anti-clockwise what we are going to take. So this part we need to find out. So let us see what are the formulas which we are going to use. So for the normal and tangential stress, we know those the formulas which we are going to use. So calculating that part here, so this way, normal stress on the plane CE we will take. So that is sigma theta is equals to sigma x plus sigma y divided by 2 plus into bracket sigma x minus sigma y bracket close divided by 2 cos of 2 theta plus tau sine of 2 times theta. So this is the particular formula what we are going to take. So substituting we will take sigma theta. Sigma x is how much? 120. So this is compressive, here the value is minus sign. So 120 minus of plus, so it is minus 180 divided by 2 plus, this will be 120 minus of minus plus 80 divided by 2 and cos of 2 times theta is equals to theta is 40 degrees, 2 into 40 plus tau is 50 sine of 2 into 40. So substituting these values and getting the value, if we do, that is sigma theta is equals to, so this value comes out to be 20. So that we are going to calculate 20 value and calculating this particular part of the things. So let us see the part of remaining value. This is cos 2 into 40 is 80, we can see, plus 50 sine of 80 we will take. So calculating this part, sigma theta is equals to, what are the answers we are going to get is 20 plus 17.364 plus the 49.240. So all together sigma theta, which is normal stress, is equals to 86.60 megapascal, or we can say sigma theta is equals to 86.60 Newton per mm square. So this is the particular calculation of normal stress. So now let us see related to shear stress. So in the shear stress part, the shear stress, that is tau theta, is equals to value, that is tau CE we will be taking, sigma x minus sigma y divided by 2 sine of 2 theta minus tau xy cos of 2 theta. So this is the particular value. So when we consider the substituting value, so 120 minus of minus plus, it will be, so plus of 80 divided by 2, then sine into 2 times theta, theta is 40 degrees, let us substitute, minus tau xy is 50, was we know, so multiplying cos of 2 times 40 angle, substituting into this comes as about to be 200 divided by 2, 100, then sine of 2 times 40 is sine 80 minus 50 cos of 80. So calculating this value, we get that particular values as the 98.480 minus of 8.682. So once we take these values, we are able to find out this value as it is 89.798 Newton per mm square. Clear? So this is the value of tau CE. Now comes So how does this is acting? Let us see. So this part, if we take how it is acting. So let us say this is the particular edge of B and C, and this part is the particular value. This angle is theta equal to 40 degrees, and here it is E. Now in this we can say that this way shear stress and this way normal stress, they are acting. So this is sigma theta, this is tau theta. We can even find out what is the resultant R, but as it is not asked in the question, we are not able to see that particular value. So now the remaining part we can find out, that is the principal stresses and the particular part of values. What we can easily find out the things of the values in this. So let us see, related to principal planes. So principal planes means which formula we are going to use? We are going to use sigma x1 or sigma x2 is equals to sigma x plus sigma y divided by 2 plus or minus half of square root into bracket sigma x minus sigma y whole square plus 4 times tau x y square is the particular value. So substituting these values, 120 minus of plus, then we will be getting this value. So we can say this as minus of minus and plus. So we will write this as minus 80 divided by 20 plus or minus half by 2, then square root into bracket 120 minus of minus plus 80 whole square plus the particular value. We can say this as 4 times multiplied by 50 square we will consider. Okay, so now this 120 minus 80 we have already known, that is 40 divided by 2 is 20 plus or minus half of the particular this value. So this is 200 means square root of 200 is 40,000 plus 4 into 50, then this is 10,000 particular value. So this comes out. Let me calculate whether it is 4 into 50 square, it comes out to be 10,000 only. Now calculating this as 20 plus or minus half, so this square root when we do, this particular value comes out to be 223.60, and calculating this value, this as 20 plus 118.8 plus or minus. So if we take sigma x1, it will be major axis, major principal plane. So we'll take plus value, it has 111.80, which comes out to be 131.80 newton per mm square. And sigma x2 is equals to, this will be minus 20 minus 111.80. So we can easily say that this particular value is going to be 91.80 newton per mm square, that too in the negative sign we are going to get these values. So this was about the particular values of the formula and what we have calculated. Now coming to the particular solutions of this, now let us see what is the angle. So tan 2 theta is equals to 2 tau xy divided by sigma x minus sigma y. Substituting this value, so 2 times 50 divided by, as this was anticlockwise, this will become as plus. So anticlockwise, here it is becoming as plus. If it was clockwise, it will be in the minus sign. So I'll just show you this part, that is tan 2 theta is equals to minus 2 tau xy divided by sigma x minus sigma y was the values. So this turns out for the particular tau tan 2 theta is equals to 2 times tau xy divided by sigma x minus sigma. So this value we are going to consider here. So this is for the anti-clockwise is not going to take. So we will take this for the anti-clockwise. This will remain for the clockwise. Okay. So this is for the clockwise part. So 2 into 50. So let us calculate. 180 minus of minus plus 80. So calculating this. So 100 divided by 200. It gets to be 1 by 2, which is 0.5. So tan 2 theta is equals to 0.5. So when we calculate the value, 2 theta is equals to tan inverse of 0.5, we are able to get that 2 theta is equals to 26.56. So theta is equals to 26.56 divided by 2, which is equals to 13.28 degrees. So theta 1, then the particular value of theta 2 is equals to 90 plus 13.2 degrees, which is 103.28, which is equals to theta 2. So this is the solution part for the particular question what we have seen. So any confusions, any part in this, let us discuss and see the things. So how this part is going to come in this section, let us move for next problem. So in this problem we are going to see what all is given data. So the stresses acting at a point in a two-dimensional system as shown in figure, determine the principal stresses, planes maximum shear stress and planes normal and shear stress on a plane AB. So they have given the plane AB and shear stress also they have given 80 Newton, then both where tension is acting 150 and 100 MPa. So let us consider this particular problem and solve this particular problem as per the given values. So going with the solution part. So solution, what all is the given data? Sigma x is given, directly figure is shown, so no need not to wait much more. So writing the values of given data which is there in the figure, we are not going to draw any figure, directly writing the values. Tau x as 80 Newton per mm square, though it is also anticlockwise, we need to understand, and theta value is given as 20 degrees. So these are the values which they have given. So now moving with the first part of our solution, that is normal stresses. Normal stress sigma AB, because they have mentioned the plane A to B. So writing the formula for this, sigma x plus sigma y divided by 2 plus of into bracket sigma x minus sigma y bracket divided by 2, then cos of 2 times theta plus tan tau xy sine of 2 times theta. So this is the value. So substituting the value into the formula, what are the given values, those we are substituting in this formula and writing. So 150 plus 100 divided by 2 and plus 150 minus 100 divided by 2, cos 2 into 20 plus the 80 sine of 2 into 20. Calculating these values, 250 divided by 2, 125 plus, this is minus, so it is 50, 25 cos of 40 plus, this is 80 sine of 40. We will get this particular values. Now calculating the particular value, if we see this particular value, how much it will be showing to us. So going with these values, let us write 125 plus 19.15 plus, this value comes out to be 61.28. So principal normal stress sigma AB is equals to 205.43 Newton per mm square is normal stress value. Now going for shear stress. So shear stress, shear stress as tau AB is equal to sigma x minus sigma y divided by 2 sine 2 theta minus tau cos of 2 theta is the formula what we know. So 150 minus 100 divided by 2 sine of 2 times 40 degrees, sorry, 20 degrees, 2 times 20 degrees minus tau is 80, so 80 cos of 2 times 20 degrees. So it comes out to be 25 multiplied by, calculating this with sine of 240, so 0.642 minus 61.28 is the value. Then coming, tau AB is the value, minus 45.23 Newton per mm square. So this is the value of shear stress. Now let us see related to the values of the thing, the numerical of the particular value. So the numericals are like this. So now see the principal stresses. So writing out the formula, sigma x1 comma sigma x2 is equals to sigma x plus sigma y divided by 2 plus or minus half of square root into bracket sigma x minus sigma y whole square plus 4 times tau xy square. Then substituting the values into the formula, so we know the values, what are the particular values. So let us substitute 150 plus 100 divided by 2 plus or minus half of square root into sigma x is how much, 150 minus 100 square plus 4 times tau is 80 square root. So calculating this value, we get the value as 25 less or minus half of the 262.5 squaring and rooting that. So that part if we divide, we get two values, 25 plus or minus 131.25. So now we are able to see that sigma x1 as the major, when we add it, so we get this value as 156.25 Newton or mega Pascal we can say, and sigma x2 will be as minus 106.25 Newton per mm square. So these are the two values. Now moving on to the next part of the thing, that is the angle. So angle tan 2 theta is equals to 2 tau x y divided by sigma x minus sigma y. So substituting the value, 2 into 80 divided by 150 minus 100, which will be equals to minus 3.2 value. So this value is 3.2. So calculating, 2 theta is equals to tan inverse of 3.2. When we take, so we get this as 72.64, and theta 1 if we take, 72.64 divided by 2, so theta 1 is equals to 36.32 degrees. So once again we find out the value of theta 1, and now theta 2 is equals to 90 degrees plus 36.32 angle when we do, so it comes out to be 126.32 degrees is the theta 2 value. So now we let us calculate the value of tau max. The tau max is equals to tau 1 or whatever we are considering, half square root sigma x plus sigma y whole square plus 4 times tau x y square. So substituting the values, half square root 150 plus 100 square plus 4 times 80 square. So this value comes out to be 0.5 So this comes out to be half square root 50 square plus 16 into 4, that is 8064 into 4 is the value what we have to calculate, because 80 square is 80 multiplied by 80 into 4 it is, so comes out to be 25600. So finally we get the answer as half of square root 2500 plus the value as 25660. So finding out this answer, so tau max is equals to 83.81. then the value of angle, the particular value of angle is tan of 2 theta s angle of shear plate sigma xy minus sigma y divided by 2 times tau xy we are going to calculate. So substituting this value into the formula, 150 minus 100 divided by 2 into 80 comes out to be 0.3125. substituting that value, 2 times theta s is equals to tan inverse of 0.3125. so calculating this part, 2 theta s is equals to 7.125 and theta s is equals to 7.125 divided by 2, which is theta s is equals to 3.56 degrees. So these are the particular final part. So we can see the answers. I'll write down only the final answers of this particular problem. So final answers we can see, one is sigma AB, which is equals to 205.43 Newton per mm square, and tau AB is equals to minus 45.23 Newton per mm square. Then sigma X1, which is 156.25 Newton per mm square, and sigma X2 is equals to minus 106.25 Newton per mm square. Then comes the value of theta 1, theta 2, then tau max, this is Newton per mm square we need to consider, and theta s. So this was the particular fifth problem. Thank you. See you in the next video.